All right, guys, welcome back to the Coin Bros Show, the number one stop shop for all things crypto, period. There's no one better,
what up?
So today we got a good show today. We're going to talk a little bit about Bitcoin is already outperforming the halving that sparked the 20K all-time high, baby. We're almost there.
Yeah, baby.
Next up, we're going to talk a little bit about PayPal CEO Shulman says he's bullish on Bitcoin as a currency.
Goddamn time.
It is about time you guys start making headlines.
Get in there, man.
It's crazy. This is the stuff we've been talking about, and now it's finally coming through.
Institutions finally doing it the right way.
So we're going to talk a little bit about that, and we're going to cap it off. Final story of the day. We are going to talk about XRP. Some people love it. Some people hate it. Rises more than 30% as altcoins piggyback on Bitcoin's wave, man. They got their surfboard ready. They see that tidal wave coming.
Bro.
They got them altcoin seasons.
Woo!
Man, I don't know about alt season. I think it's always alt season this year.
If it ain't Bitcoin season, it's alt season.
So you know stay tuned. We got some really cool stuff coming up. And thank you guys for being here. Let's get it going.
Yee. Bitcoin, break it down. Bitcoin, break it down. Cause 21 million, there ain't enough to go around.
Bitcoin, break it down. Bitcoin, break it down. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Coin Bros Show, and shout out to all the Ledger gang.
Welcome back.
I want to say what's up to my host with the most.
Yo.
My tricky trader. The fiat hater himself. Crypto Jess.
What's up, guys?
We're going to get into it, man. There's some good stuff to talk about. But as always, before every one of these videos, we are brought to you by Velas.
This video is sponsored by Velas. Velas stands for Virtual Expanding Learning Autonomous System. Velas blockchain uses AI-enhanced delegate proof-of-stake consensus for high-volume transaction processing without sacrificing decentralization or security. For more information, go check them out at velas.com. That's V-E-L-A-S.com.
All right, let's talk about the first story. Bitcoin is already outperforming the halving that sparked the 20K all-time high.
That's what I'm talking about.
If you were around to be there for that 20K all-time high, well, man. Thank you guys for holding on. I bet you are celebrating now because I am.
Thank you
I'm
for
stoked.
Holding, man. Yeah, we went down with that ship.
Big time. So William Suberg wrote in Cointelegraph, I'm reading this, using figures from Coinmetrics and Statistican, Clark Moody charts BTC's halving index compares Bitcoin's progress since May's halving with the 6 months after 2012 and 2016 events. Goes on to read, the results show that in terms of price action, Bitcoin is beating its run to 2017's all-time highs of 20,000. Only 2012 produced a higher upside. So they're saying for every 4 years or every bull run, only time it ever multiplied quicker was in 2012. And that was when Bitcoin was only at like $12.
That's insane.
Right? So if you do the math on that, right, it says 6 months after the halving, Bitcoin's price is 2.2 times higher in 2020. And in 2016 was more like 1.3 times. So we've already doubled.
More than doubled.
Yeah, a little under double, right? And it's saying that, you know, if you really think about it, you have all this institutional money coming in. All this, it's a different type of money that's flowing into Bitcoin.
Dude, it's a different land. It's a different climate now. You know what I mean? Like when the Bitcoin hit 20,000 in 2017,
mm-hmm.
there was lots of hype, lots of FOMO, lots of general people getting into it, you know what I mean?
A lot of FOMO.
Exactly.
Just straight FOMO.
And no one knew what the hell was going on.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, we FOMO'd in, you know, we got in just a little bit before that. And then now, like when the FOMO does hit to the general public, it's going to be different, man.
Like, it's like we have this crazy institutional money coming in. You have the PayPals of the world. Yeah. You have just...
Also, like if you look at the market cap right now for Bitcoin, or not just Bitcoin, but the entire market cap, mm-hmm. we're not even at, I think we're now at $500 million or half a trillion, right?
Yeah. That's the entire market cap of cryptocurrency.
And before that, when Bitcoin was at this price, we were way closer to a trillion.
I think it was, I think we almost capped out at like 800 and something billion.
Yeah,
and that's when Bitcoin was right around 19,000. So that just says two things, right? You got a lot of dominance on Bitcoin right now. People are throwing, it's all these major, you got the Michael Saylor, right? That's the name?
Mm-hmm.
That guy's, you put in $500 million of his own money.
That's a lot of money, man.
You know, like what happens is you get all these huge investors and institutional money coming in and they all follow suit, right?
Yeah.
The crazy thing is the FOMO that comes from retail and just the average person is just starting. I was on Facebook and it's funny, you can feel it. You can just go through your like the Facebook feed and you start seeing little comments.
Yeah.
I want some Bitcoin. Oh, can you pay me in Bitcoin?
Yeah, the interest is coming back.
And we're almost at 20K and
well,
it's
and
just
speaking
starting.
About general public and interest on our next topic,
mm-hmm.
PayPal.
Yep.
Right? PayPal CEO Dan Schultzman says Bitcoin's usefulness as a currency will ultimately prevail over the buy and hold ethos in an interview with CNBC Squawk Box on Monday.
I actually saw that interview today, man.
This story was on CoinDesk, just so you guys know. And yeah, man, like PayPal got in, right? And now, like, since that happened, I feel like the rise in Bitcoin is...
It's just starting, man.
Yeah.
It's like he said in his interview today, he was basically saying that you're pushing out to 300 million people, giving them access. Mm-hmm. And this is just in the U.S. right now. This isn't even worldwide, right?
Yeah.
And what else can happen besides the entire world getting behind it now?
We're not even a huge player in the crypto space. You know what I mean? There's people in other countries that are way bigger than what we are. So
it's just the fact that these major companies are starting to get behind it. I remember in 2017, you couldn't say anything about Bitcoin without 10 other people saying it's a scam.
Yep.
Oh, stay away from it. Oh, it's going to plummet to zero. Yeah, and this is coming from major players in the game, right? So now they're all changing their tune.
Yeah.
And you can't find a single person saying it's a scam anymore. Yeah. Like, go on YouTube.
Well,
I dare you to find
one. When you have big companies like this coming in and saying that they're putting it on their platforms, it's not a scam anymore.
Stop hating.
I mean?
Stop hating, guys.
Just follow along, man.
Join the train. It's too late. It's not too late.
Hop on that Bitcoin train. We are here with open arms.
Yeah, man. You're going to be there with Peter Schiff just hanging out with his gold bars on an island somewhere, man. Yeah. The party's going to be over here. You're going to be chilling out.
We got this fake gold over here. Just rock one of these, man.
I like gold too, but you know what I want? I want a gold-plated ledger. That's what I want. That's the only gold thing I want.
Hell yeah.
All my money in that ledger,
gold-plated.
Baby.
Gold-plated. Coin Bros engraved ledger gang.
So, yeah, let us know. Oh, and by the way, you guys, make sure you hit that subscribe button, like it. If you do so and you send that to 10 other people in a change letter, you will become rich, I promise.
Yes.
Hit that subscribe button. So, for the last story of the day, let's talk about XRP. It rises
XRP people out there, you know you love XRP.
XRP rises more than 30% as altcoins piggyback on Bitcoin's wave, man. They got their surfboards ready. That wave is coming. They're paddling out.
Who are these guys picking back off of? Bitcoin.
Yeah. I mean,
that's who they're picking.
Look, man, this whole industry is about money, right? It's about making money. I don't care what coin you're into, man. Get behind the coins that are making you money.
Yeah, man.
I mean, the tech is cool. Yeah.
I mean, if the tech works, awesome. But,
man, let's get this money.
Let's be real.
I mean, honestly, I don't have any XRP. I used to. In 2017, I bought some. I missed it when it hit that rise, right?
Yeah.
So let's just read a little bit what they say in here. Let's just read a little bit. Okay.
XRP has a surge to 16 months high, leading a pack of cryptocurrencies all benefiting from crypto's rally towards historical levels.
Mm-hmm.
That's insane. XRP is up 22%. The native asset to XRP ledger development by payment-focused blockchain firm Ripple Labs climbed to as high as 43 cents before retiring back to 41. At press time, reaching the highest price point since July 2019, according to CoinDesk 20.
I think we're even higher than that as we're recording this.
I think that's what we talked about earlier. We said it was at 55%. It's up 30%.
Yeah, it's 50. It's almost 54 cents. It's crazy. I mean, Ripple got all the way up to almost $4 in 2017. I remember that. I was just watching the screen,
I was just like, what is going on here, man?
I mean... I'd blow my mind if it got back up to those levels.
I can see it though happening if it's maybe on the piggyback of Bitcoin's rise right now. Why couldn't it do it when it actually explodes?
I mean, if you got in any time in the past 2-3 years, you are stoked
right now. Solid, bro.
So I mean, I don't know if I'm picking it up right now, but
yeah, no. I mean, there's still.
But hey, man, all you XRP people out there, good on you, man.
Keep
you stuck with
holding.
It. You guys are crazy, man. The XRP army is goddamn nuts. You guys are in
a
good way. I'm not talking S. I'm saying
they're animals.
You guys are animals. But if everybody was as passionate as you guys in this, we'd probably already be at 50, 50, 60K in Bitcoin. Ethereum would be going through the roof, man. So make sure you guys let us know in the comment sections what you think. And, write us a little something. This is our first show back in a while.
Yeah,
we've been stacking them sats.
We're going to be doing little things like this. We're going to be doing other separate little segments of different kind of stuff, just bringing you guys
content.
Everything crypto.
Just content, man.
Everything
we're here.
Crypto.
Let us know what you think of our new setup. If you hate it, you love it. You like my monkey head with the crown.
Yeah, suits us.
And we have another music video we are shooting on Friday right after Thanksgiving. So we're going to have that hopefully out in the next couple weeks.
Y'all be ready for that.
You guys going to like that one, boy?
Stack of shots.
Hey, man. Coin Bros out. Ledger gang.
Peace.
Peace.